Good evening and welcome to the holiday edition of the Teacher's Lounge. Of course, just like you're at home enjoying the holidays, well, Boss and I are too. So again, if you hear a little rapscallions or, well, a little background noise, just focus your ears. It's the same format as always. She is the boss.
Hello.
She tells you what to do. I am the bell. Ding. I tell you when to do it. And this is the post-Thanksgiving and the very grateful edition of the Teacher's Lounge. All right, boss. First of all, hope everybody had a good holiday, good Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm. It was very nice.
Good, good. We are now post-Thanksgiving, looking forward to Christmas. I've heard enough Christmas music today to last me till Christmas 2021.
And how was your Thanksgiving?
Very thankful.
Okay.
Well, a lot of Zooming, a lot of fooding. You know, I was in the Zoom room, I was eating. But all in all, different but good. Black Friday, a little shopping online. Oof. I'll get to that. Well, the teacher's lounge might need to cut expenses, boss.
I don't step foot outside on Black Friday.
Oh, it's out of control. It's out of control. But a lot to get to. A lot to get to and a lot to look forward to, boss.
Mm-hmm.
We are now in the holiday season. Episode 6.
Wow, have we done that many?
It's 6, boss. It's episode 6. This is a lot, again.
Wow.
And, of course, I have to say it. I'll do it before or after. Information received on the teacher's lounge cannot be used in binding arbitration. Yes, the lawyers are still working, even when they're off, boss. Cannot be used in binding arbitration. So information recommendations are not legally binding. All right, we got that out of the way. Of course, everything you need to be able to contact us is on our Facebook page. That is the Teacher's Lounge. So again, go to the Facebook page, like us, obviously. I have to tell people what to do, boss, so that's your job.
Don't forget the apostrophe.
Don't forget the apostrophe. Again, boss tells you what to do. I just tell you when to do it. So do it now.
And when you get to that page, you'll find all the other ways you can connect with us. Instagram, YouTube, and our website links, they're all there. So all you need to do is go to Facebook, and then from there, you're golden.
So again, go to Facebook. She's telling you what to do. When to do it? Now.
Now.
To do it. I tell you what to do. She is the boss. I'm the bell. I tell you when to do it. Let's get started. The rapscallions are restless. So let me go to Hot Topics. Item 1, boss, even though, of course, it's a holiday time, and I'm very thankful, for Hot Topics like inappropriate gear worn by teachers.
Yeah, it's teachers this time.
Yeah, I've talked about parents, but again, teachers fall victim to the same thing. If you're a teacher, I know you're results driven, you're oriented to having the same habits. Just because you've been Zooming and wearing pajama pants at home, boss, I should not see you getting out of the car on your one of two hybrid days, coming out in the comfy cozies. They can see you in the classroom, okay? They can actually see you. I don't need pajama pants and a Starbucks cup being brought into school. That is inappropriate. That means not.
We know you're run ragged, but
I understand you're a little frazzled right now. I get it. Things are out of, they're helter-skelter, if you will. But listen, mix in some professionalism. You're only there 2 days a week. I don't really want to see or have visions of what Mrs. Whomever is wearing when she's at home on her couch grading math assignments. Put on the full school uniform, khakis appropriate, no berets.
No berets.
Berets are banned. No berets in the teacher's lounge. But of course, you've got to be able to wear school appropriate gear if you're going to be there for 2 days. That's mandatory.
Otherwise, the kids will never look at you the same.
And you'll never get the kids back. I mean, think about it. Think back to when you teachers or you parents were actually, well, students. What if Mrs. Smith or Mrs. Davis or Mr. Doley from science came in with a Rutgers sweatsuit on and his button-down shirt?
Ooh, yikes.
I don't really want to. Or maybe your gym teacher is wearing slippers. Not something I want to see, boss.
Maybe one of your teachers likes to wear Irish kilts. On the
I
weekends.
Don't want to know that.
Yeah.
Boss,
do you really want to see that?
Boss, I don't want to see a kilt. I don't. Not on anybody. No. No, boss. That's just not a vision I want in my head. All right. So again, appropriate wear by teachers important, just as it is for parents. Parents, we didn't forget about you. We didn't want to get on you as bad, but teachers have to do it as well. Let me talk about items such as this. I know that everybody's getting content from different sources. People are in a hurry to put up content. Listen to me. Be careful with what you're showing and sharing with your students. So let's assume that I'm showing a science photo and I'm talking about penguins, if you will. Penguins are pretty harmless, aren't they, Bob?
Yeah, why not?
I mean, I've seen a number of movies with penguins. That's a pretty fair subject. Penguins don't, they don't wear tuxedos.
Happy Feet.
Happy Feet is a great movie. Again, but they're not dressed in the wild because, well, they're penguins. However, humans should be. And when putting in the terms for
male penguins huddling together,
You might get a different type of male penguin huddling.
A.K.A. a human male.
Okay, I mean,
without dress.
Are they Chippendales? Are they, I mean, is that what I'm going to get? Am I going to get the cartoon Chippendales? Or am I going to get some guy with a tuxedo bow tie and his chest out?
Right, please preview these videos before sharing with your class.
All I'm saying, look at what you're showing. Watch what you show. Inspect what you expect. Yeah, I want the little, what's the Chippendales? They're Dave and Glenn, whatever. They talk really fast. The next thing I know, you pull them up, and I got some guy in a bow tie flexing, or I got Chris Farley.
Yeah, you don't have Theodore, Alvin, and
Simon, the Chipmunks. I don't want that. I don't want the Chipmunk male dancers previewing somewhere in America. I don't need that, boss. Don't need that in my classroom. That is not classroom approved. So again, note what you're showing to the kids, please. Note what you're showing. The rapscallions in the background will approve. Or before 8 a.m. Item 3. Teachers, this goes directly to you. Listen, I see you coming in the morning with your bags and your satchels and your dollar diet Cokes that are actually a liter of Coke, allegedly, before 8 a.m. Or sweet tea or Sprite. Or whatever brown liquid is in that cup.
Right.
Listen to me. I'm not asking what's in it. All I'm saying is be careful and don't leave said cup uninspected or unattended. The reason being, let's assume that perhaps someone is having a bad day or maybe they're having a little PTCD, as I like to call it. Post-traumatic COVID distress. I just made that term up.
Good one.
Boss, you're the specialist. You're the licensed professional. Hopefully we won't have a copyright on that.
Right.
But so you're coming in and you need something well to help your morning of your hybrid phase in. And maybe that liter of Diet Coke contains a little additive. Maybe a special boss sauce.
And we speak of this from real life experience, folks.
Actual experiences. That goes to whether you're worried about administration, knowing what's in that cup, or people in your classroom. Either way, you don't want to have any non-Coke substance.
And you've drank almost maybe, let's say, half, and you obviously will have to use the bathroom at some point, right?
You're going to have to go.
Well, what's going to happen when the teacher's in the bathroom bell?
Well, when the teachers are away, the rapscallions will play. And I just don't want my young rapscallion taking a sip while his friends giggle and then slurring his words in second period because he's had, well, a shot of something that he shouldn't have.
Right.
I don't want to be on a local action news because of kids ingesting some substance. Boss, again, the lawyers are already texting. That's what's going on.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. They're not on vacation either. But again, be careful with your cups. Be careful with your belongings, understanding that kids are curious. And sometimes they're going to
dare each other to drink the teacher's Coke,
which may contain something other than just a Coca-Cola. And, well, all of a sudden, Steven doesn't feel too good because he may have got a special shot in the arm, if you know what I mean.
This concludes our round of Hot Topics.
Hot Topics in. Lot of things in the oven. We're on our way to Profession of the Day. As you know, we are now after the holidays, and after the holidays are over, there's always things to throw away. But people in the waste receptive profession. Sometimes they take it, well, a little too seriously. Sometimes things go a little like this. Yeah. You can put it right there, lady. Just put it down. I see it right there. Put the trash right there.
Okay, please. Okay.
Well, first of all, lady, those are leaves. This is trash. Then there is garbage. And then there is refuse. I don't know if I'll take a brief minute to inform you.
No. I have my recyclables here, my
garbage
trash.
Garbage comes from the French, which means to throw away. Gar, meaning throw, and bage, meaning away. Garbage. Trash simply meaning waste, and then there's refuse. Now, if I look at your typical can, ma'am, are you paying attention? If I look at your typical cans, now these banana peels and, of course, recyclable foils, these are to be put in different areas. Now, this garbage, toilet tissue, and perhaps these look like soiled garments, may be placed in another area that have been used for recluse. Now, being the trash ma'am, I'll ask you not to handle that, please. I am the professional.
You're certainly knowledgeable about trash.
Man, if you throw it away, it goes my way, all right? I'm just saying.
Okay.
If you throw it away today, I've got something to say.
Listen, I was just out here raking leaves.
Understood, though, man. But again, people don't take their trash, garbage, seriously. I would hate to say au revoir to something that was valuable, that had been misplaced simply in a receptacle by your home and not been taken care of. Mistaken for trash. It happens almost 30% of the time, you know.
Trust me, there's nothing but trash here.
As you would think. As you would think, ma'am. I would just say nothing but trash except for those slippers you seem to be wearing. Huh. All right, boys. Let me look through this. Gloves on. Lids up. End
okay.
Over.
You know what? He looks like he's waving you to go. The guy in the truck there?
Are you supposed
to spend this much time at each house?
Well, of course, I try to spend a little bit of time at each household. A little bit of prevention helps for a little bit of invention. But hold on, Sydney, don't run away from me. By the way, is my wallet in there?
Excuse me?
Have a good day.
Just get this trash off of my lawn, please.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, get the trash off your lawn. Yeah. All right, kids, of course, the rapscallions are circling the wagons, but of course, it's still time for us, my favorite segment, the professional speech tip of the day. And of course, that's brought to you by Stacy Boss, licensed speech professional. And again, I have to admit, lawyer's disclosure, boss, the information given on the teacher's lounge is not to be used for binding arbitration. It is only a recommendation of a licensed speech professional, licensed in the state of Ohio.
Right.
All right, boss. Put a little bit of your boss sauce on this. I got this on the Facebook page. That's the Teacher's Lounge. That is the Facebook page where we get all of our contact information.
Mm-hmm.
Here's my question, or here's the question that we got. And this is relevant, especially now. What can I do at home to help my child's speech development? A lot of kids at home longer during the holidays, boss. You know, kids, the rapscallions are here, but they're getting ready to go back, remote or hybrid. But what can I do at home? I'm here with them every day. What can I do?
Well, I get this question a lot at the schools by parents. What can I do at home? And honestly, it's super simple.
Simple to you or simple to them? Come on, boss.
Both.
Everybody's both. Not. Okay.
And
boss,
I've heard.
Say it to me like I'm not a SLP.
I will.
Right. I'm just saying.
So, because parents don't really know what's developmentally appropriate at what age,
mm-hmm.
what I usually say, what you can do at home, if I don't know the child's speech errors or, you know, never met the child or whatever. If I have met the child, then I can give them more specifics. But this is a general tip.
Just give me the general.
So the general tip is, let's say your child says "nake" for snake.
Okay.
All you do is you say, "Look at me." Point to your mouth and over-exaggerate the S. You mean snake. And then you move on. That's it. You don't have them repeat you. You just have them look at your articulators, aka lips, teeth, tongue, palate, and then you move on. It's you don't want to draw too much attention to it, especially if you don't know if it's appropriate or not for them to be misarticulating it.
So wait. I'm at home. I noticed that my child, son, person who lives with me has a speech error. I don't harp on it. I don't say...
No, you're going to stop, say, look at me.
Look at me.
Use your pointer finger and point to your mouth, and then exaggerate the sounds. Let's say he says white for right. You just say, look at me. I'm pointing to my mouth. Right.
Right.
And then move on. And you wouldn't believe... Some of my friends have actually said how much that they didn't even have to see the speech therapist because just doing that at home worked. This is probably pending. There's no other health issues with your child. And it's just strictly maybe an articulation error.
Sure. But again, tips I can use at home, which is always so important, especially during COVID-19. Kids are home more, and obviously you're going to be engaging them. You're going to be talking to them more. And the quicker you can get this thing turned around, boss, I'm guessing the easier it is later on?
Absolutely. You can prevent all the testing at school. You can prevent them going on IEP and just have them develop their speech right at home.
Home speech. I like it. That's what I'm talking about. All from the SLP, the boss. So, boss, I had another speech question, of course. You get these speech questions from the Teacher's Lounge on Facebook.
Let me hear it.
So it says, and I'll read this one. Boss, my child's speech objectives are the same from year to year. I.e., he was working on his S's last year, working on his Z's last year, and now here we are in 2020 working on the same thing. Is this a mistake? Is this an error? What's going on?
Okay, well, I'll start by saying, it definitely could be a mistake.
Okay.
What
else could it be?
I would urge you to look at the entire objective and not just look at where it says S and Z. It could be where last year he was working on S and Z in isolation or maybe just in words. Hmm. Maybe only in the initial position of words. And maybe he has mastered that. Or he was working on S and Z and they wanted him to do it at 60 or 70% accuracy.
So wait, when you say in isolation, what does that mean? Just the S.
Yeah, with no context around it, just isolation. Okay, so look at that last year's objective, and then I would bet you that if you looked more closely at this year's objective, even though it still says he's working on S and Z, maybe he's working towards 80 or 85% accuracy. Hmm. Maybe he's working on S and Z in phrases, in sentences, in conversation.
Like zipper. Or
I see a zipper, or maybe in spontaneous conversation. So if you look at the rest of the objective, it's probably different than last year.
Little twinges or subtle nuances. Can I use the word nuance?
Twinges.
All right, I'll use
tweaks, if you will.
Tweaks. I'm the licensed substitute professional. That means I have no license at all. I'm the substitute professional. But go ahead.
Now, if you see that it's the exact same as last year, maybe it's that your child did not master S and Z in isolation or in words, and they're still continuing that same objective. I will tell you, if they haven't met the objective in a couple of years, we usually don't continue to work on something when they're not making progress after a long period of time.
Do you revisit these things? Do I get to look back and say, what is this, 2020, 19, 20? Do I look at it in a vacuum, I guess?
You could always ask the SLP to at least maybe check in on the student and see if they are developing or on their own pace.
Got it.
Just something to note there that... students not making progress on objectives year after year after year, we don't continue speech and language services.
Wow. So there is an end date. There is an end game.
Yes. Okay. It's speech and language services is not forever. It's not forever. And I know that's hard to stomach for some parents because it's kind of like you're saying, what, you're giving up on my kid?
Well, I think it's more, and correct me if I'm wrong, boss, I'm trying to correct something, and once it's corrected...
If it's corrected, of course, they wouldn't receive services. But if there's no progress and the same error is being repeated over and over throughout the years, you have to think of it as we're not a teacher, we're a provider who bills. To bill for something year after year after year with no progress, for whatever reason it is, it could be lack of motivation from the student, it could be absences from school, and they miss all their speech sessions, it could be another major health issue that inhibits their memory. Though all those things are valid reasons to discontinue speech services. And I know that some view it as giving up on your child, but that's not it at all.
Well, you know, when you put it in the license frame of being a licensed provider. If I am, you know, not seeing the progress, I can't continue to bill if I don't have substantial improvements.
Yeah, so that's also unethical.
Unethical. That's a big word. We want to avoid that. The lawyers do not like unethical on this program. All right.
So I hope I cleared that up for whoever asked the question.
All right. Well, that is. That question was found again on the Facebook page, The Teacher's Lounge, where all of our contact information can be noted.
We will see you back here next week on The Teacher's Lounge.